مسلم قرآن اسمك I hear the calling of them With it we unite We are special only If we follow his light The way of Muhammad Calling to paradise ya Allah We are your servants, ya Allah La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh Brothers and sisters and viewers around the world Jazakumullahu khairan for tuning in today to a brand new show, The Servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The show is aiming to highlight the benefits or the benefits of being from the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trying to highlight those actions that we can do which will bring us the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make us amongst those who are in the position of the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A quality that we will take today is one of the qualities which will allow us to gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is the attribute of taqwa. Having taqwa is an attribute that will, inshallah ta'ala, gain for us the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With us to explore this further is our esteemed sheikh and teacher, Sheikh Saeed Al-Gadi. Sheikh Saeed Al-Gadi is an imam and teacher at Al-Muntada Al-Islami Trust in UK, London. He has a background in Sharia, and he also has a speciality in education with a postgraduate diploma in that. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Shaykh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Shaykh.
Jazakallahu khairan, Shaykh. Barakallahu feek. Shaykh, so our discussion today is about taqwa, and how will taqwa enable us to gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we may be amongst those who are in that rank, the beloved of Allah. Shaykh, first of all, what is taqwa?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. All praise due to Allah alone, we praise Him, thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness, repent to Him, seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead, and whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. Taqwa or piety linguistically means to have a shield or a protection against anything which is harmful. And in Islam it means to put a protection or a shield between you and Allah's anger, between you and Allah's punishment. To put a shield and protection between the person and Allah's anger or punishment by doing righteous actions and staying away from the evil and the bad deeds.
Barakallahu feek, Shaykh. Can we say that taqwa is only to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?
No. Taqwa has a broader meaning than this. Has a more comprehensive, it is a very comprehensive concept. And fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only a part of it. Part of taqwa. Ali radiallahu an, the companions, when he defined taqwa, what did he say? He said, Al-khawfu min al-jaleel wal-amalu bil-tanzeel. He said that taqwa, piety, is to fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the first one. The second aspect, wal-amalu bil-tanzeel, and to adhere to Allah's revelation, to Allah's instructions and commandments, to adhere to them, to stick to the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah. وَالْعَمَلُ بِالْتَنْزِيلِ. And then he said, وَالْقَنَاعَةُ بِالْقَلِيلِ. And to be content with whatever Allah ta'ala has given to you, even if it's little. وَالْإِسْتِعْدَادُ لِيَوْمِ الرَّحِيلِ. And preparing yourself for the day of departing, which is a day of when you leave this life, the day of leaving this life, the day of your death. So you prepare yourself for this is taqwa. So taqwa has a broader meaning, and it is a more comprehensive concept. But fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is part of it. But it's not only fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So does it imply perfection and not falling into any sins?
And it doesn't imply that, because we as human, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us in such a nature that we may fall in sins. And Allah ta'ala, when he spoke about the pious people, the one who acquire piety, he said that they sometimes they fall in sins. Although they are pious, but they fall in sins. Allah ta'ala, the Quran said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا إِذَا مَسَّهُمْ طَائِفٌ مِّنَ الشَّيْطَانِ تَذَكَّرُوا فَإِذَا هُمْ مُبْصِرُونَ. Indeed, the pious ones, the ones who have piety, whenever they fall in a sin, whenever the shaitan whispered to them about anything, okay, they will remember. They may fall in something which is haram or in a sin, but they will always remember straight away. They will always recover quickly. They will realize that they were sinning, and they will stop, and they will repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the difference between the believer and the pious one and the one who is heedless of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that the pious person, he falls in sins, but he will recover quickly and he will repent quickly and return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala quickly. إِذَا مَسَّهُمْ طَائِفٌ مِنْ الشَّيْطَانِ تَذَكَّرُوا. They will remember and they will return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِذَا هُمْ مُبْصِرُونَ. And they will know their way. But the heedless person, he will fall in a sin, another sin, and he won't care at all. And the sin for him is like a fly came into his nose and he goes like this. He won't think of it. But the believer, he will think of his sins like a mountain which is about to fall in him.
Subhanallah.
Whenever he falls in a sin, he will repent straight away to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Sheikh, I'm just thinking, as iman has levels, does taqwa have levels as well?
It's a good question. Some ulama have actually said that the taqwa has as well levels. But it is not really accurate. But I can mention some of the levels that they've spoken about. They said that taqwa has five levels. The first level is to put a protection between you or to protect yourself from the kufr, the shirk, okay? To protect yourself from the kufr. The second level of taqwa is to protect yourself from falling in the evil actions and the sins. The third level of taqwa, let's go like this, okay? The third level of taqwa is to protect yourself from that which is doubtful. You protect yourself from the shirk, kufr, and then from the haram, evil actions, from that which is unlawful, and then you protect yourself from that which is doubtful. Al-halalu bayyin wal-haramu bayyin. The halal is clear and the haram is clear, and between them there are many things which are doubtful. فَمَنِ اتَّقَ الشُّبُهَةَ. The one who protect himself from that which is doubtful, فَقَدْ اسْتَبْرَأَ لِدِينِهِ وَعِرْضِ. Indeed, he has saved his honor and his deen. So, protecting yourself from the shubuhat, as in the hadith, فَمَنِ اتَّقَ الشُّبُهَات. The one who stays away from the shubuhat, the one who protects himself from falling in that which is doubtful. So, protecting yourself from the doubtful actions, or doubtful deeds. This is the third level. The fourth level is to protect yourself from falling in that which is lawful, mubahat, that will keep you away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? I'll give you an example. You may say, for example, eating is halal, isn't it? But if you eat so much, okay, and you feel tired to pray at night. Okay, if that's something which is lawful, but that affected your ibadah. So you stay from that which is away from that which is lawful. Okay, you don't eat so much, so therefore you will have energy to worship Allah Ta'ala more. So you stay away from that which is allowed in order to please Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Okay, and the fifth level degree of taqwa, which they said, it is to protect your heart from being occupied by anything but the love of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, which is extremely difficult.
Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala.
Let's be realistic and saying that to give your to give the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala priority and precedence over any other love in your heart. This is possible. Inshallah ta'ala.
Subhanallah. May Allah give us taqwa. Jazakallahu khairan, Shaykh, for this Allah wonderful introduction into the meaning of taqwa and what it really means. The question I want to ask you, and I'm sure many of the viewers want to ask you, is does taqwa really enable us to gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?
Yes, it does. Taqwa, of course, it is one of the main attributes that will enable you to gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala in the Quran, what did he say? Bala man awfa bi ahdihi wattaqa. Nay, but the one who fulfills his promises and fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he's pious, he has piety. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Indeed, Allah Ta'ala loves those who are pious. In the other verse, Allah Ta'ala said as well, أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Indeed, the one who are beloved to Allah, the ones who are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have no fear shall come to them. And they won't be grieved in the hereafter. وَلَهُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. And then when he described, what did he say? He said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. Those who are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of their main attributes is that they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have piety. كَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. They are mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are heedful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fearful of Him. May Allah make us all from them, inshallah ta'ala. So having piety will enable us, of course, to gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and will make us beloved to Allah, the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakallahu khairan, Shaykh. I would like to ask you more about the virtues of taqwa. But inshallah ta'ala, we'll take a quick break, bi'idhnillah ta'ala, and we'll return back. Dear viewers, please stay tuned. We're going to hear more virtues about taqwa. جزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم.
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله.
Real Talk Cafe is a place where young people get together to share their thoughts and ideas.
Islam
about the crazy world in which they live in.
When we have had correct leadership produced societies that have benefited all humanity.
The program is not designed to get into the halal and haram of music, because it's not what I want to get into.
So I would take my CDs from the car, and then to the house, to the office, and, you know, triangulate, because I needed it.
You know, fast food is killing you. Even the normal food that you go in at home with all the preservatives and, you know, chemical subsidies they have to put in there to keep it fresh and whatnot. They say, well, you know, I'm just simply choosing my poison now.
A lot of people I know, they just not smoke. Just so, because, you know, four guys, they're standing and talking around, they all smoke. So, you know, that sort of socializing thing is a huge factor.
The entire staff at Hoda would like to wish you a wonderful and blessed Ramadan.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters, welcome back to the Servants of Allah. Today we're going through taqwa and how taqwa will enable us to become those who are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just before the break, we asked our Shaykh Saeed Al-Gadi about the meaning of taqwa and what it really means. And now we would like to know more virtues about taqwa, so that way, inshallah ta'ala, we can try and attain it and become those who are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, Shaykh, are there any more virtues that you can tell us about having taqwa?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Indeed, there are many, many virtues of being pious. Many virtues of acquiring piety. And subhanAllah ta'ala, in this life, if you ask about this life, if you are a pious person, you will be able to gain two main things. First of all, you will gain economic prosperity. As Allah Ta'ala in the Quran, when he spoke about the people of the book, what did he say? He said, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا. If the people of the book, if the people of the scriptures were to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be pious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَكَفَّرْنَا عَنْهُمْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ. We would have erased their sins. وَأَدْخَلْنَاهُمْ جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ. And we would have admitted them to Jannah. Jannah, the boundaries of Jannah. وَلَا دَخَلْنَاهُمْ جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ أَقَامُوا التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلَ لَأَكَلُوا مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ وَمِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِهِمْ. And if they were to, if they implemented the gospel and the Torah, their books, their scriptures, they would be, Allah Ta'ala would have given them the prosperity in this life. لَأَكَلُوا مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ. They would have whatever they want of provision in this life, from the heaven and from the earth. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran as well, when he spoke about being pious of him and being fearful of him, what did he say? He said, وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. And whoever fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will find for him a way out from all troubles, from all difficulties, from all calamities. Allah Ta'ala will provide for him from a way that he never expected. Allah Ta'ala will give him a sustenance beyond his expectation. And this is if you are mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Also, the second benefit and virtue of being pious and being fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that Allah Ta'ala will facilitate all of your affairs, will make things easy for you, will make all of your affairs easy.
وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ يُسْرًا.
And whoever fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whoever has piety, Allah Ta'ala will make all of his affairs easy. SubhanAllah. This is in this world. SubhanAllah. And there are many, many, many great virtues of being pious to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being righteous, and being fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us piety in this life and give us the benefit of it all in this life, inshallah ta'ala. Sheikh, I really want to ask you about, as you know, the messengers and the prophets were sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a reason, and that is to establish tawheed, to establish his oneness in this world. Is there any relationship between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending messengers and gaining taqwa, or us gaining taqwa?
Jazakallah khair. Very good question. If you ponder upon many of the statements of the prophets in the Quran, you will see that they were always focusing on worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and gaining taqwa. Worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, oneness of Allah ta'ala, tawheed, and gaining taqwa and acquiring taqwa. Allah ta'ala, when he spoke about Musa alayhi salam, what did he say?
وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ وَإِذْ نَادَى رَبُّكَ مُوسَى نِئْتِ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ.
And when Allah ta'ala called upon Musa alayhi salam to go to the people who are wrongdoers, people of Fir'aun, then he said,
قوم فرعون ألا يتقون.
Go to them, the people of Fir'aun, the people of Fir'aun who are not fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So the purpose of sending the messengers is to call people towards taqwa, towards this concept, which is piety, after the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why we have in the Quran in many verses, for example, Nuh alayhi salam, what did he say to his people? إِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ أَخُوهُمْ نُوحٌ أَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. When the brother, the people of Nuh, the brother, Nuh, when he said to them, don't you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Don't you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can't you be pious and be fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And likewise, إِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ أَخُوهُمْ هُودٌ أَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. And likewise, Hud alayhi salam, the same word, أَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. Don't you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? صالح إذ قال لهم أخوهم صالح ألا تتقون. And also شعيب إذ قال لهم شعيب ألا تتقون. When شعيب said to his people, don't you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and acquiring the concept of taqwa was one of the main purposes of sending the messengers, so they call people towards Allah Taala, the oneness of Allah Taala, and then to become pious and become righteous in this life.
Jazakallahu khairan, Sheikh. Sheikh, I would like to just shift the focus a bit back to the virtues and benefits of having taqwa in this world, so that way, inshallah ta'ala, we can gain a deeper understanding and we can, inshallah ta'ala, see the effects of taqwa in our life. Is there any link between having taqwa, as you mentioned before? Can you explore further the link between having taqwa and relief of hardship and difficulty in this life?
Yes, subhanAllah ta'ala, if you have taqwa, if someone has a taqwa, as I said before, Allah ta'ala will find for him a way out from all difficulties, from all calamities. Allah ta'ala will give him a relief from all stress, from any stress. مَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And also, Allah Ta'ala will facilitate his affairs, make things easy for him in this life. If you fear Allah Ta'ala, make things easy and possible for you, inshallah Ta'ala, in this life. But you might ask, is taqwa so important for us in this life? Yes, it's very important. It's very crucial. Why? Because it is the advice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's Allah's advice to us to become pious and to become fearful of Him. It is Allah's advice, Allah's direction, Allah's recommendation to us and to the people before us. وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. Indeed, we have recommended the people of the book before you, وَإِيَّاكُمْ, and yourself. أن اتقوا الله, to fear Allah, to be mindful of Allah, to be heedful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's Allah's advice, and that's why we have to take it on board, we have to implement it. Furthermore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about meeting Him, the day in which we're going to meet Him individually. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to us, prepare yourself with what? With taqwa for this meeting. What did he say? وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّكُمْ مُلَاقُوهُ وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and know that he's going to meet him. Prepare yourself with this concept of taqwa. When he spoke about the hajj, what did he say? He said, الحج أشهر معلومات فمن فرض فيهن الحج فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج. Then we spoke about the provision of the Hajj, he said, وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى. And prepare yourself for the journey of Hajj by having some provision. By having some provision. But he said, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. But the best type of provisions is the provision of taqwa. Equip yourself with taqwa for the meeting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter, so prepare yourself with this matter, with this concept, with this aspect, which is taqwa. Have taqwa for that meeting. Because we're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, individually. as in the hadith, I swear by whom my soul in his hand, that every one of you will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, without any interpreter, or defender, or protector.
إِن كُلُّ مَن فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ
Everyone in the heaven and the earth.
إِلَّا آتِ الرَّحْمَنِ عَبْدًا
Except that he will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. As a slave.
لقد أحصاهم وعدهم عدا.
Allah SWT has counted them with full counting. And He knows every one of them, the people.
وكلهم آتيه يوم القيامة فردا.
And every one of them will meet Allah SWT alone. Without anybody. Without anyone being present. But yourself and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So prepare yourself for this meeting by having taqwa. By having taqwa. And one of the ulama, Imam al-Razi, rahimahullah, said that the wise person is the one who does three things before other three things approach him. The one who leaves this life before this life leaves him. And the one who prepares his grave before he goes into it. And the one who pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you do these things, if you prepare yourself with taqwa, of course you are from the successful ones, inshallah ta'ala, in the hereafter and in this life, inshallah ta'ala.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us taqwa. Sheikh, mashallah, it's been a great pleasure having you and enlightening us more about this great quality of taqwa, which I'm sure you would agree with me is easier described and actually acted upon. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to act upon the advice. And inshallah ta'ala, we should have a lot more questions. And I'm sure the viewers at home have a lot more to ask or would like to know more about taqwa, inshallah ta'ala. But time has left us. And inshallah ta'ala, until next time, inshallah ta'ala. Dear viewers, jazakumullahu khairan for listening. And until next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Muslim, Quran is my guide. I hear the calling of them, with it we unite. We are special only if we follow His light. The way of Muhammad, calling to paradise. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, we are your servants, Ya Allah. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun.